The UN's gender parity strategy is one of the reforms that Secretary General Guterres has brought forward in the organization to make the United Nations fit for purpose in the 21st century and beyond. What he's targeting is 50% senior female leadership across the board by 2021 and across all of the secretariat and the rest of the system at all levels of personnel by 2028. Now, this strategy is not just fair, but it's also essential in making us more effective in the work that we do. As we know, women in most societies are socialized differently than men. We have different life experiences and different work experiences. This is key for the UN and our work. We need to enrich our policy making by hearing from women and having women involved in decision making at the UN. This is going to help us make our work much more effective on the ground. It's also going to make us much more relatable to the people that we serve, and in particular the more than 50% of the people that we serve on this planet who are women. As the head of a peacekeeping mission and a peacemaking mission on the ground in Cyprus, I've really come to appreciate how essential it is to have women and more women in our operations on the ground. For example, our female police officers are able to relate in a much different way with the women that we serve in the communities in and around the buffer zone. Secondly, in terms of the peace negotiations, we are able to promote and lead by example with the women that are involved in supporting the talks and showing that it's essential to have women at the table. In my view, one of the most exciting aspects of having more female leaders in the UN is to work with our male counterparts to redefine what leadership means at the United Nations, for now and into the future. I think we need to bring women's perspectives and experiences into the mix and see what it is that we all can share and contribute to make us the most effective leaders possible, both on the ground and at the Secretariat.